Hello everyone, this is Vaseem from Edureka and I welcome you all to this session where I'll be talking about range in Python. So without wasting any more time, let's take a look at the agenda for this session. So first of all, I will talk about range function in general and then I will discuss the range parameters. After this, I will explain a few examples including for loop, float numbers and other examples as well. And finally, I will tell you a few points to remember while working with range in Python. I hope you guys are clear with the agenda. Also, don't forget to subscribe to Edureka for more exciting tutorials and also press the bell icon for latest updates on Edureka. Now, without wasting any more time, let's try to understand what exactly is range in Python. Range is an inbuilt function in Python which returns a sequence of numbers starting from 0 and increments to 1 until it reaches a specified number. The most common use of range function is to iterate sequence type. It is most commonly used in for and while loops. So let's take it up to Jupyter Notebook and I'll show you how you can use a range function in Python. But before that, I'm going to show you how you can get a range of 6 numbers. So if you type the range function and specify the number 6 over there, it's going to start from 0 and go until 5 and it's not going to incorporate the last number, which is 6. So let's go to Jupyter Notebook and I'll show you guys how you can use the range function in general. So we are in the Jupyter Notebook, guys. So what I'm going to do is I'll just specify a range function. So let me take a variable and in this I am just going to type range 6 and now I'm going to print A over here. Let's see what the output is. So it's starting from 0 and will go until 6. And to get the idea of how the numbers are going to be, I'm just going to put this inside a list, guys. So for this I'm going to use the list constructor and inside this I'm just going to specify the variable A which has the range and I've specified the number 6 over there. Now if I print A again, it's going to give me the list starting from number 0 and it will go until number 5 and it's not going to incorporate number 6 over there. So this is how you can use a simple range function, guys. This is a very basic example just to show you how you can actually use range function. So let's go back to our PPT and I'm going to talk about the range parameters now. So what exactly are the range parameters? So basically there are 3 range parameters in Python that we use. So first of all, we have a start parameter and this is the starting parameter. It actually specifies the start of the sequence of numbers in a range function. The next one is the stop and it is basically the ending point of the sequence. The number will stop as soon as it reaches the stop parameter. For example, if we have a stop parameter as 6, as I have shown you in the example, it's going to stop at number 6 and it will only print the numbers before that. And last but not least, we have a step parameter. This parameter actually is the steps or the number of increments before each number in the sequence is decided by the step parameter. So let me take an example to show you guys the parameters that we are going to use. So let's say I have a variable B. Inside this I have a range function. So the starting parameter should be 0 and then the ending parameter I'm going to take 11 so that the number will be between 0 to 10. And for step, let's say I want to increment it by 2 until it reaches the ending parameter. So now when I print B over here, we have a range of 0 to 11 and the step parameter is 2. So again, I'm going to put this inside a list and I'm just going to use the list constructor and it's going to convert our range function into a list. So let's print now. So I'm just going to print B over here and I'm getting the numbers as 0, 2, 4, 6, 8 and 10. So we are starting from 0 and then we have the ending point as 11. So the numbers are between 0 to 10 and using the step parameter, I've actually incremented it by 2. So we have the second value as 2 and then we have 4 and so on. So this is the basic example of the range parameters that we have in Python. So using these range parameters, it revolves around all the range functions, guys, and we can use it for different purposes as well. So for instance, let's take an example and we're going to use range with a for loop. And I'll show you what you can do with the range function when you put it inside a for loop. So let's say we have a for loop and we are using the range from 0 to 10. And when I print this, let's see what the output will be. Output will be basically from 0 to 9. But just to get that idea, let's go to Jupyter Notebook and we'll do this. So I'm using the for loop. So for I in, let's say range, starting point is 0. Let's say ending point is 10. And then again, I want to give the step as 2. Don't forget to put the semicolon over here. Otherwise, it will show you syntax error, guys. And now I'm just going to print I just to get it inside line. So when I print I over here, I'm getting the number as 0, 2, 4, 6, 8. I'm using a for loop, guys, and iterating through a range, which is a sequence. I don't have to use any list parameter or a list constructor to actually print all these numbers. I can do this by using the for loop. And this program is actually printing the even numbers starting from 0, and it will go around 10, which is why it has stopped at 8, because the ending point over here is 10. For instance, I'm just changing the 10 to 11. There'll be one more addition, which will be 10 over here. Similarly, if I do this as 13, there'll be 12 as well. So this is how you can actually use a for loop inside a range function, guys. Because, you know, we can treat range as a data type as well. So we are basically iterating through a data type, which is range. Now moving on, let's take a look at another example, which is float numbers in range. So the range function does not actually support float or non-integer numbers in the function. But there are ways to get around this and still get a sequence with floating point values. I'll show you a program which you can write, which shows an approach that we can follow to use float in range. So we have a function over here, which is fRange. And inside this, I have three variables, which is start, stop, and step, which is basically the range parameters as well. But inside this, they are just variables. And then I have a logic for the function, and I'm using it in the for loop to actually, you know, iterate through the sequence. So I'll show you guys. So let's say I'm using the range function, and I put the floating point values over here. Starting point is 0.1, and let's say ending point is 1.0. When I print this, I should be getting an error, which is saying a type error that says float object cannot be interpreted as an integer. So it's a very important point that I'm going to tell you about when I'm talking about the points to remember, guys, because you can actually only specify the integer type values in these parameters that we have, which is start, stop, and step. Now we'll talk about that function that I was talking about. So we'll have a fRange, and inside this I have start, stop, and step as well. So this is my function, and I'm going to define the logic now. So I'll just write I is equal to start, and then I have while I is less than stop, yield I, and I plus is equal to step. So we have actually defined our function over here, which is fRange. So now I'm going to use it in a for loop. So for I in, let's say, fRange, and inside this I'm just going to pass the parameters. Let's use the same parameters we were using before, and let's say this, and for step let's say 0.2, and now I'm going to print this I. It's showing me the output as 0.1, 0.3, 0.5, 0.7, and 0.8. Okay, it's actually showing me a little interrupted output. So this 0.8.99 is supposed to be 0.9. This is supposed to be 0.3. So we're getting these values that I'm not sure why we are getting. So this is all about float numbers in range and how we can actually make a function for this purpose. And this is basically working the same as any range function, but instead we can use the floating point values as well. So let's move on to the next topic that we have, which is reverse range in Python. I'm going to show you a program, and it will tell you how we can reverse range in Python. So this is the program, guys. I'm using the for loop, and inside this I'm actually using the negative value for the step. So I'll show you in the Jupyter notebook how we can actually reverse the range. So let's say for I in range, so for the starting point I'm using 5, and the ending point should be 0, and the step is going to be -1. So this -1 is actually playing a very important part, and when I print I over here, I'm getting the value as 54321. So instead of -1, let's say if I do 1 and change this to 10, and now when I print this, I'm getting the value as 56789. So instead of going in the forward direction, I can just change it to -1, and I'm going to get the values in reverse. So this is how we can actually reverse the range in Python, guys. It's a very simple logic while declaring the parameters, and that's how you can actually reverse the range in Python. Now let's take a look at a rather important topic, guys. I'm sure you must be very intrigued to know what is the difference between range and XRange. So the major difference between range and XRange is that range returns a Python list object, and XRange actually returns XRange object. And for the most part, range and XRange basically do the same functionality of providing a sequence of numbers in order however a user pleases. And XRange does not generate a static list like range does at runtime, And it also uses a special technique known as yielding, which creates the values that we need. And this technique is used by the object known as generator. And if you require to iterate over a sequence multiple times, it's better to use range instead of XRange. And in Python 3, XRange does not exist anymore. And so it is ideal to use range instead. Anyway, we can actually use this tool, which is known as 2-to-3, to convert the Python code from Python 2 to Python 3. So there is no need to actually worry about here. We can actually use this tool to convert the Python code from 2 to 3. And since the Python 3 does not have XRange, it's always recommended to use range in Python. So let's take a look at the next topic that we have, which is range function example. I'm going to show you a few examples of range function so that you can understand it better. So the examples that I'm going to show you are concatenating two range functions. And the next one will be accessing the range function using the indexes. And then there is converting range to list as well. So let's go to Jupyter Notebook, guys. So first of all, I want to do the concatenation of two range objects or range functions, you can say. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to import chain from iter tools and use the chain over here. And inside this, I am just going to specify both the ranges that I want to concatenate. So range 2 will be, let's say, starting point is 10 and ending point is 20. Now for I in result, print I end is equal to, let's say, now when I print this, I'm getting the numbers as 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 until 10. And then after that, the second range function comes into picture, which is 10 to 19. Okay, I'll just do this 21. So this is how we can concatenate two range functions using the chain from iter tools. And I have actually used this chain function to create a concatenation of two range functions, which is range of 10. Actually, the starting point will be 0 and it will go until 10. And then you can have the range function starting from 10 and go until 20. So this is a very basic example of how you can concatenate two range functions. So let's take a look at the next example that I was going to show you, which is accessing the values or accessing the elements inside a range function using indexes. So I'm sure you must be aware of indexing. It's called a technique in which you have the index number starting from 0, it will go until the end of the range. And on each of these index numbers, there'll be values present. So for example, if we have a range starting from 0 and going until 10, the numbers will be 0, 1, 2, 3 and go until 9. So the index number will start at 0 and it will go until 9. So basically it will be the same for that. But if let's say we have a string and it has the value Edureka, like the alphabets from Edureka. So at the letter number E, it's going to be 0. And at the last index, that is the letter A, it's going to be 7. So let's see how we can use the indexes to access the values from a range. So let's say I have a range function, which is starting from 0 and go until 10. And let's say I want to access the value at the index number 3. And then let's say I have B, which has a range function, let's say 0 to 5. And I want to access the number, which is at the index number, let's say 4. Now when I print this, I'm getting the value as 3 and 4. So in the range function, which is stored at the variable A, at the index number 3, the value is 3. So if we start from 0, 1, 2, 3, we can actually know which value is stored at the index number 3. Okay, I'll just make a few changes over here. I'll start with 1 over here to make it very clear to you instead of 0, because the index numbers also start from 0. Now when I print this, okay, I'm getting an error. Just range objects index out of range. All right, so I'll just do this. Now we have the output as 4 and 3. So on the variable that is A, the range function starting from 1 and go until 10. So the output is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 until 9. And the index number 3 will be at the number 4. And if we take a look at the next one, which is B, range function is starting from 1 and going until 5. So the output is 1, 2, 3 and 4. So on the index number 2, which is starting from 0, so 0, 1, 2. On the index number 2, there will be number 3 over here. So this is why we're getting this output, guys, and we can actually access the elements using, you know, indexes in a range function. So let's take a look at the next example that we have, which is converting a range to list. I have actually, you know, shown you this in the first example only when I was printing the value of the range function. So it's very easy, guys. I'll just specify a variable with a range, let's say 0 to 10 and step 2. I'll take one more variable, and inside this I'll use the list constructor, and I'll specify a over here. Now let's say I want one more variable c. I'll just use the list constructor and specify the range over here only. So I'll just start from 0 and go until 10. Now when I print b, and let's say I want to print c as well, the output is I'm getting the list from 0 to 8 because I have used the step as 2 over here. And we are getting the list as 0 going until 9 because we have 10 over here. So instead, if I do this as 11, we'll be getting the numbers from 0 to 10. So this is how we can actually convert a range to list, guys. And I have forgotten something to tell you guys. So when we are using the step values, I want to tell you about the increment with positive and negative step. So we can use the range function in Python to increment and decrement step values using positive and negative integers. Let me show you a program that we can get the sequence numbers using in both orders using positive and negative step values. So let's say I have a for loop, and for I in, let's say, range 0 until, let's say, 20, and I am using the step as 2. Now when I print this, I'm getting the values from 0 to 18 because I have used the step as 2 over here. And let's say I start from 10 and I want to go until 0, and I'll just put minus 2 over here, I'm getting the values like this. So instead of 0, I can actually use, you know, minus 8 as well. So this is how I can actually use increment or decrement with positive and negative step values that we have in the step parameter. So with this, we have come to the end of the session. I'll just tell you a few points to remember while using a range function in Python, guys. So first of all, the range function in Python only works with integers or whole numbers that we have seen while we were using the float numbers in the parameters. And argument passed in the range function cannot be any other data type other than integer data type. So if you're using a range function, the parameters has to be in the integer data type only. And all the three arguments passed can be either positive or negative integers. So I've shown you that in the negative step when I was using the minus 8 value in the step parameter as well. So for that, we can use it for all the three parameters. Now, talking about the step argument value, it cannot be 0. Otherwise, it will throw a value error exception. So I'll show you that as well. We're back in the PyCharm. So instead of minus 2, let's say I want to say 0 over here. It's going to show me a value error, which is range argument 3 must not be 0. So this is one really important point to remember, guys. And the range function in Python is also one of the data types that I've also told you. And you can access the elements in a range using index values, just like a list data type. So that we have also done, guys. And now that we have come to the end of the session, don't forget to subscribe to Edureka for more exciting tutorials, and also press the bell icon to get the latest updates from Edureka. Thank you.
I hope you have enjoyed listening to this video. Please be kind enough to like it, and you can comment any of your doubts and queries, and we will reply them at the earliest. Do look out for more videos in our playlist and subscribe to Edureka channel to learn more. Happy learning!